Okay, so as a cosmetologist who specializes in natural hair for the past 10 years professionally, this sounds great in theory. However, I think there's a lot of things that a lot of people aren't considering or thinking about with this. And I do like that there is more of a shift now to teach students about natural hair and styling. But in order to really dismantle a system that really did not cater to natural hair, you have to rebuild it from the top down. You can't start from the students and go the other way. So, what I think should have happened is I think they should have required cosmetology instructors to have a certain standardized level of competency when it comes to natural hair care, natural styling, and even just understanding the culture and heritage around natural hair, because there's so many different aspects to our hair besides just styling it. Our hair carries our history, our culture, and there's a certain level of respect that does not come, that one doesn't acquire just from learning how to style it. You know, if you're still referring to someone's hair as nappy, or if you're still using derogatory languages, or if you're using insensitive terms such as, you know, some people prefer to have their hair referred to as locks versus dreads. You know, so a sense of awareness is also necessary when having this conversation as well. Now, look, I get it. We're not going to change everything overnight, but these are all things that need to be taken into consideration. The reason why this does not work is because, as someone who's went to Empire Beauty School and I went part-time, they actually do include in the curriculum for you to learn how to style natural hair. It's in the book. Most major beauty schools, at least in the state of Georgia, I know Aveda, I know Paul Mitchell, I know Empire for certain. They do cover natural hairstyling. The issue is, despite that, there's still a bunch of hairstylists today who are not comfortable with styling and handling natural textured hair. And the issue is because the cosmetology instructors in these beauty schools are not familiar enough with natural hair, with styling it, with proper technique, with teaching proper tension, with understanding the cultural awareness that comes with it. And so they're not able to pass it along to the students in a way where they too will feel comfortable handling it. On top of the fact that even though they do cover it, there's a lot of things that they get wrong about natural hair because they are teaching natural hair through the lens of someone who's never had natural hair, never been knee deep with natural hair, and let's face it, isn't even black. So, for instance, let me show you a couple instances of this. All right, so this is my textbook from Empire Beauty School. It is the CLIC International Cosmetology Career Concepts. I'm sure they have newer editions now. I graduated back in 2015. In the book, they do have a section talking about natural hair styling. Specifically, I want to go to coiled hair. It says coiled hair is medium to tightly curled or coiled and is highly dense with minimum elasticity and movement. The texture ranges from fine to coarse and is extremely fragile, requiring extra moisture. To enhance the natural pattern, suggest products that moisturize, stretch, and define the curl. Because this hair type easily tangles, frizzes, knots, and breaks, suggest twisting and braiding techniques to define the curl pattern. So, this just of itself is already, I don't want to say incorrect, but it's inaccurate. And it's because they are basically comparing natural hair, Afro textured hair, to its straight Caucasian counterpart. Our hair actually has the most elasticity, especially when it's handled wet. But based on that just brief description, it already puts this mindset in a student that is learning about hair that this is the type of hair that's the most challenging, that I probably don't want to encounter, that I don't want to deal with. Because it makes it sound like there's nothing positive about this hair texture besides like trying to make it something that it's not. And it focuses on enhancing the curl instead of focusing on learning how to work with the texture and the curl pattern. So I know this all sounds great on paper, but at the end of the day, if the instructor is not able to really give the student what they need to be competent in the actual cosmetology industry when it comes to natural hair, once they get their license, they're just going to avoid it. And we're going to be back at square one. And even in my experience with beauty school, as you can see, they covered natural hair. They covered natural hair styling. So it's not like we weren't exposed to it at all. We also had clients that came in and, you know, had natural hair as well. But most of the students didn't want to deal with it. Most of the teachers didn't know how to deal with it. So, you know, they just threw them on the students and had them figure it out. And even in my experience with paying over $20,000, there were times where I was in beauty school and my instructors would have me teach the class because they knew that I was knowledgeable and competent in natural hair because they weren't able to. They didn't know how to style. They didn't know anything about it. If there's so many stylists today that don't know how to do a basic two-strand twist, a basic flat twist, a basic comb coil, how to retwist some locks, how to properly apply proper tension for natural hairstyling, because natural hairstyling emphasizes parting, emphasizes styles where your hair is confined in a certain way, and if you do not teach proper tension, everybody's going to be walking around here bald-headed with traction alopecia. So this is really, really important. And again, I think this is a step in the right direction, but the issue is we're getting ahead of ourselves. And if we get ahead of ourselves, that step is going to turn into a trip and we're going to fall and bust our ass. So I don't know what needs to be done to make this work, but it starts with properly teaching educators. It starts with changing the verbiage and the sensitivities around natural hair as it relates to how it's taught in these books. And I mean, I get it. They're going to use straight hair as a comparison to natural hair because that's what these people who wrote the book are familiar with. And if you're curious to know what they look like, I'll show you. Yeah. So until we can get more people of color and people who are well-versed and experienced in natural hair and all the facets and different varieties that it comes in, in terms of styling, texture, curl pattern, all of that, we're going to continue to have the same problem that we have. I'm not against it. I want it to be done the right way because right now, we have such a disconnect when it comes to people with natural hair and hairstylists, and I completely understand. I think that a lot of hairstylists fall short, but it's not their fault. It's because they weren't adequately and properly prepared to handle natural hair. But, I mean, I want to know what y'all thoughts are on this, and how do you think we can go about to just make the right changes to make sure that this actually sticks and it makes sense.